Church, and happy Sabbath. It is good to be with you this morning, and I'd like to extend a warm welcome to all of our members, our guests, those who are joining or viewing online. We want to extend a warm welcome to you as well. And I just want to say this, I am reminded every Sabbath that we're able to meet in this building how much of a blessing it is to come together in fellowship. God is good, and I'm just glad we can be here together. I'd like to draw your attention to the screen. Our connect number is 970-279-3432. Perhaps throughout the service, you have a question, or maybe you have a comment that you want to share with the pastoral team. Maybe you're a first-time guest, and you're not sure what this church is about. Shoot us a text with your information. We want to connect with you. We want to answer those questions, and we would love to engage with those comments. Now, over the past few weeks, you may have seen a tagline, "Each One, Reach One." And some of you may be asking, why? Why am I seeing this tagline, "Each One, Reach One"? Well, in a line, it would be that it's the Gospel Commission. God actually challenged us, commanded us, for each one of us to reach one. This morning, we got a little video we want to share with you on what that can look like from Nancy, our chaplain at Camping Academy.
Here at Campion Church, our goal is each one, reach one. In my Bible classes, I'm going through the Encounter curriculum with my seniors, and I shared a story about Pastor Jonathan Stepak and how he came to a brand new church dressed as a person who was homeless. He wanted to see how his new church would react, and so I challenged my students, let's see if we tried that here at Campion, how our church would react. So the very next Sabbath, she walked through the door.
You've been here before?
I haven't.
Oh, well, welcome.
Thank you. Do you know where the pastor's office is?
Yes, it's two doors down here, but he's up on the platform today. So have you been, do you know where the platform is, the truck?
I don't know where it is.
Well, let me take you to it.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. My Bible teacher challenged us to look through the eyes of a homeless person, and she asked our class if we would like to go to the church and dress up as a homeless person to see how the church would react. I thought it would be a great opportunity, and my heart just pulled, so I thought I would do it. So this Sabbath, I came and I dressed as a homeless person and brought a trash bag and saw how the congregation would react.
As soon as I saw her come in the door, I didn't recognize her, and I saw the trash bag, and she asked where Pastor Nestor was. So I was happy to show her where his office was, but he was up on the platform, so I took her around to where our sanctuary. And after church, I contacted Nestor again, and I said, Nestor, there's a homeless girl here that has never been here before, but she wanted to meet you. So I waited after church, and I couldn't find her anywhere.
After I came through the doors, I decided to come here and sit down. I was watching the beginning of the service. It hadn't started yet, but I was waiting for the countdown. No one really talked to me. Everyone just pretended like I wasn't here or stared at me. I didn't feel the overall reception that I did from the greeter. It really made a difference.
We have brought this story to you in hopes of encouraging you that we can be maybe a little bit more like our greeter, to be kind and compassionate and Christ-like to everyone we encounter, especially this holiday season. So over the next few months, from the church and from the school, we encourage you that each one reach one.
Thank you, Nancy, for your hard work on this video. And it is a good reminder, we never know who is in our midst. So keep that in mind. And if Amira, you're watching, thank you for taking part in that. We've got a few things we want to highlight to you this morning, our Campion 3. The first one, we have a couple of opportunities this week to help families who are moving into their new homes. We have the Carini family that is moving in on Wednesday, and then we have the Amick family that is looking to move tomorrow. So if you have questions, if you're interested in helping them, their addresses are in the bulletin today. If you're willing and able to help, let one of us as pastors know, or let Teresa know, and we'll make sure to get you connected to those families. Campion number two. This next Thursday, Christmas Eve, we will be having a special candlelight service right here in the sanctuary at 4 p.m. Here's the opportunity, the invitation for each of us to reach one. Invite a friend, invite a neighbor to come and join you. If you can't come in person, join us online. You don't want to miss it. It's going to be awesome. Campion number three. Today and next Sabbath, we will be taking up a Christmas tree offering, which will benefit our very own HMS and also an organization within the Loveland community. So during our opening hymn here in just a moment, feel free to come up to the Christmas tree here to my left, your right, and drop off the offering. It will go to bless HMS and an organization in our community. Thank you for your generous contributions and happy Sabbath. Thank you.
Spirit by thine advent.
Loving God, we come together to celebrate your Son, whose birth restored hope in our world. In this season of joy, we pray for those who need that hope today, for those in the darkness of despair who need the hope of your light, for those who are burdened by loss, who need the hope of your comfort, those surrounded by conflicts and war who need the hope of your peace. And those without refuge, the oppressed, the forgotten, who need the hope of your compassion, mercy, and justice. Help us. Help us, your church, to fulfill your purpose on earth. May we be your arm of hope, reaching beyond the walls of worship into the world. We thank you for the gift of your Son, who alone can satisfy the longing heart. Until that day when we see him face to face, we wait with joyful expectation in the blessed hope of his return. Amen.
Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him.
Come to heaven. In the evening, God called out to Adam and Eve, but they hid from him. "Why were you hiding?" God asked. And Adam replied, "We were afraid and hid because we are naked." Then God asked, "Who told you that you were naked? Did you eat from the forbidden tree?" Adam confessed that he had disobeyed, but blamed Eve, and Eve blamed the snake. God told them, "Because you have sinned, you will not live forever in the garden with me. From this day forward, you will work by the sweat of your brow to grow food, and in pain you will bear children. You will labor over the dust from which I made you until the day that you die, when you will become dust once more."
Come, ye sinners, poor and needy, lost and ruined by the fall. If you tarry till you're better, you will never come at all. You will never come at all.
righteous rule that will not end. Lay down all your bitterness, turn from sin's toils and distress, find the grace and perfect rest. Oh, children, come.
Genesis 22, the angel called out to Abraham, because you obeyed God and were willing to sacrifice even your only son, the Lord repeats to you the promise, your descendants will outnumber the stars of the sky and the sand on the seashore. Through you, I will bless all the nations on earth, and from your bloodline, my only son will be born.
So here I wait in hope.
hope is coming for those who walk in spiritual darkness, for you will see a great light. I will give you a son that all who face certain death may find life through him. He will become a great leader and will be called wise and marvelous counselor, strong ruler, eternal provider and protector, the Prince of Peace. Leading with justice and righteousness, his government will be the last, and his reign will be forever.
Isaiah chapter 11. From the roots of David's family tree, new growth will sprout. A branch will blossom and bear fruit. He will have the Spirit of God judging his people with compassion and justice. And in that day, the wild beast will no longer stalk the weaker animal. Both hunter and prey will live peacefully side by side. Even a little child will lead them without fear, for the garden will be restored. Creation will be free from harm, and all the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord.
Jesus, born to set the sins and sins release us. Let us find our rest in thee, Israel's strength and consolation, hope of all the earth thou art.
Dear desire of every nation, joy of every longing heart.
Born thy people to deliver, born a child and yet a king, born to reign in us forever, now thy gracious kingdom bring. By thine own eternal Spirit, move in all our hearts alone.
By thy all-sufficient merit, raise us to
Nazareth, a girl named Mary was engaged to Joseph, a descendant of David. One day, the angel Gabriel appeared to her. "You will have a son," he told her, "and you are to call him Jesus. This child will be the Son of God, the promised hope. The Lord will give him the throne of David, and he will rule over his kingdom forever." And though Mary did not fully understand how this would happen, she was obedient and said, "I am God's willing servant. Let your word be fulfilled through me." Then the angel left her.
Name it is the name of Jesus.
death could not hold you. The veil tore before you. You silenced the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring the praise of your glory. For you are raised to life again.
You have no rival.
Jesus.
You have no equal.
Jesus.
Now and forever,
Jesus.
God, you reign.
Jesus.
Yours is the kingdom.
Jesus.
Yours is the glory.
Chapter 2. When the Roman government ordered a census to be taken, Mary and Joseph traveled to Bethlehem to register. While there, Mary, we know, gave birth to a son. She wrapped him in cloth, and because there was no room anywhere, she placed the baby in a manger used for feeding hay to the animals.
Forevermore. No way.
given for us. Noel, Son of God and Son of Man.
In the fields outside of Bethlehem, a group of shepherds guarded their flock of sheep. Suddenly, an angel appeared before them, and the sky was filled with brilliant light. "Don't be afraid," said the angel. "I have come to bring you good news. A child, the promised Savior, has been born in Bethlehem. You will find him wrapped in cloth, lying in a manger." The hills echoed with the sounds of angels singing glory to God. And then, as suddenly as they had appeared, they were gone. The shepherds left immediately and found the child just as the angel had said.
The skies to sing to us below. Unafraid that something is about to change, knowing it's the very thing that we need most.
So we wait.
So we wait.
So we cry.
Fall on us this holy night. Let the world sing Gloria. The light has come, our death undone in wondrous love. Let the world sing Gloria. To say, see the night disappear in heaven's light. Suddenly, the world made right. The
we pray.
So we pray.
So we rise.
And we rise.
Beyond amazed
by love divine. Let the world sing Gloria. The light has come, our death undone, in wondrous love.
Matthew chapter 2. After Jesus was born, a group of astronomers noticed a new star in the sky. Familiar with the ancient prophecy, they knew that this event signaled the birth of the long-awaited hope of Israel, the one who would be their king. So they followed the star and led them to the place where Jesus was. There, they bowed before him and offered gifts worthy of royalty, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Kings of earth on a course unknown, bearing gifts from afar, hoping, praying, following yonder star. Silhouette of a caravan painted against the sky. Wise men searching for the Holy Child. One king held the frankincense, one king held the myrrh, one king held the purest gold, one king held the hope of the world. A star hangs over Bethlehem, a journey ends in the night. Three kings trembling behold the glorious sight. Heaven's treasury,
one king held the frankincense, one king held the myrrh.
blessed ye Mary, gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray.
Oh, tiny baby born to wear a crown. One king have a frankincense, one king have a myrrh, one king have the purest.
Before the world was made, Christ existed. He was with God and was himself God. Out of darkness, shining as the light of life, he created everything that lives. After the fall, the world was filled with darkness again. So the life-giving light came to the world in human form. Although he was born into the same world that he made, many people saw him as a stranger and rejected him. Those who recognized him then and now receive his light and become God's children. And this is our living hope. The light of life shines in the darkness. This true light is the one and only light, and all who see it have seen the light of God. No one, no thing, not even the darkness, can extinguish it.
This unfamiliar feeling, a bitter sweetness in the joy that to this mother's heart comes stealing as Mary holds a baby boy. What is this thrill, this new emotion that to her face? What is this love from such devotion that lies the darkness of this place? The thrill of hope, a weary world rejoices. The thrill of hope, the only light. The thrill of hope.
On fire with glory,
on fire with
thrill of hope, oh, hear me, angel voice in above. Oh, hear me, angel voice in above. Oh, hear me, angel voices.
The thrill of
was born.
We'd like you to stand and sing with us right now, Go Tell It on the Mountain.
Go now, as messengers of God's hope. Where there is darkness, shine the hope of His light. Where there is conflict, spread the hope of His peace. Where there is despair, share the hope of His gift of eternal life. And may we live ever in service to Him, whose promise was fulfilled, whose hope is restored, and is alive in us through the birth of His Son, Jesus Christ, forever and ever. Amen.